Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and this is the amazing new Dunlop Justin Chancellor signature wah pedal, and it's bloody amazing. Justin Chancellor is the bass player for the mighty Tool, a dude and band known for sculpting some of the most unique and awesome tones on the planet, whether it be guitar, bass, Maynard's voice, or playing in 1116-4, or whatever crazy time signature it is. My missus is a huge, huge Tool fan. And when I try to headbang at their concerts, she's like, no, you just sway at a Tool concert. You just take it all in and sway. And now you can sway this rocker back and forth with the new Justin Chancellor signature wah pedal. But it's way more than just a wah. This is actually three effects in one. There's a Cry Baby, there's a UK filter sweep, and like you heard in the intro, an amazing fuzz built in. I play guitar most of the time. I'm not really much of a bass player. I know my way around a bass, but that's about it. However, bass wahs are very, very close to my heart. I used a bass wah with guitar for years. You get that beautiful kind of low-end thump and those soaring harmonics. It sounds like more of a filter than a wah pedal. So after all these bass tones, I'm gonna show you what this sounds like with a regular guitar and a 7-string guitar, just to show you how versatile this can be. To look at, it looks quite intimidating. You're used to a wah just being a wah pedal with maybe some controls on the side. There's lots of controls on this, but it's super easy to use and well set out. This foot switch on the top right of this wah pedal switches between the two main wah circuits. There's a Crybaby circuit, which is lit up in orange, and the UK filter circuit, which is lit up in blue. Each have their own independent volume and Q controls. The volume controls how loud you want the wah effect to come in, because it does boost the frequency by 400 hertz anyways, but you can boost that even more or even take it down. This in the manual, it says start with all the controls at noon and work your way from there. The Q control actually narrows or widens the frequency filter width to make it narrow or big sounding. It's quite unique. It's hard to explain with the wah. You've kind of just got to feel it under your foot. So it's like a tight, fast wah or a more of a big sweeping wah. You can do a lot with this pedal, and they both share the same controls. Below that, in red, as you can see, are the fuzz controls. There's a fuzz drive control, a tone, and a level control. And they just do what it says on the tin. How much fuzz do you want? Do you want your fuzz to be bright or dark? And the level, well, the volume controls how loud you want that fuzz to be. The little switch below that turns it on and off. Now, this little switch at the side that you notice me turn in, that makes this little bottom light red. That means you can use the fuzz independently of the wah. And it's a beautiful British sounding fuzz. However, when that little side switch is out, the fuzz is only engaged with the filter or the wah. And you can turn it off with this foot switch where the actual controls aren't lit up anymore, and it is just the filter or the wah by itself. So that's just the wah by itself, and the filter by itself doesn't actually do as much as the wah. Kind of only use the filter with the fuzz because it sounds kick-ass. It's almost like a Q control, like a filter, like the intro you heard. So I kind of slowly bring it in and let it sweep away, or you've got your fuzz on, say, during a verse. All cuts out for a second, the drums stop, and you're just there going. Kicks back in. You can do a lot with this pedal, and the cool thing about it being a bass wah, exactly the same as the old Crybaby bass was, is the fact that you haven't got to click it to turn it on. It's spring-loaded and auto-engaging, so as soon as you touch this pedal, it turns on, and as soon as you lift your foot off the back, it goes off. The last little control is this little dial down the bottom here, and that is a bypass delay. That controls how much of the effect you want on once your foot's off the wah. I've got a max right now because I want you guys to hear the full effect of this wah, but you can dial it back if you, for some reason, want to dial it back. Justin Chancellor sometimes wants to dial it back, but I sure don't because it sounds kick-ass. for a different reference, this is the Cry Baby doing the same kind of thing. So it's much more of a wah kind of vocal, has a lot more of a vocal characteristic to it as opposed to the UK filter, which is just like a... makes your bass sound like more like a synth. The Dunlop Justin Chancellor's signature wah runs on either a 9-volt battery or a 9-volt power supply, and you're hearing it through this beautiful Blackstar Unity Bass 60 and my good old Gibson Thunderbird with TuaTech cables. Now, that's all the wah crap. Let's hear what the fuzz sounds like. Let's really crank it and dial it back just to show you the differences between the fuzzes. And the tone control, let's bump the tone up. I feel like I'm swaying at a Tool concert. Bring the tone back. Now, let's hear how good this pedal sounds with electric guitar, shall we? So this is it with a regular guitar into a Boss Katana on the Crunch channel. Let's turn the fuzz on and have the UK filter turn. Move over to the Cry Baby, because this is going to get crackers. Aye, that's what I want. Well, that's one of the coolest tones I've got out of a guitar in a very, very long time. Let's see how it handles a 7-string. So this is an Ibanez 7-string. I'm only getting the dirt from the Boss Katana now. I'm not actually using any of the fuzz features on the Justin Chancellor Dunlop. Now let's turn the fuzz on just because I can. Now, Now, I genuinely believe that's all the side specs and sounds I can get out of the Justin Chancellor signature wah from Dunlop. Let me know what you think down below in the comments. This is one of my favorite pedals of 2021, and I'm not even a bass player. It just sounds absolutely fantastic in all three of its ways of functioning. When you mix them all together as well, that is a nice recipe right there. Let me know down below in the comments what you think of this amazing little pedal. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music-related content. If you want any more information on the new Justin Chancellor signature Dunlop Wah, get your fine self to PMTonline.co.uk by tapping one of the links in the description box down below about this fantastic wah, or call into one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram, and now Facebook. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of this with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.